Pow Pow Power Wheels were the toy to have in the 1980s. Powered by its own rechargeable batteries and electric motors, these mini vehicles single-handedly put pedal cars out of business. Me, my sisters, and 11 cousins had a set of super rad grandparents who purchased one of the first Power Wheels in 1986. The Power Wheels Golden Eagle Jeep was eventually passed down to me in 2013, allowing me to introduce my kids to Jeeps how I was. As a kid, I remember the Jeep being slow off-road and unable to climb even the shallowest of hills. I wanted to improve on the original design. I decided to up the power by 4 times and add go-anywhere rubber tires. Replacing the no-traction stock plastic wheels is not a new idea, and several hobbyists have done this already. After a good deal of research, the method of choice to connect the new wheels to the drive motors is a mix of rubber hoses, PVC pipe, and band clamps. Safety and durability are paramount when creating something for kids, and the existing adapter design does not provide either. In theory, the design challenge is simple. Create a design that couples this with this. Two parts that are not designed to go together. SOLIDWORKS paired with Stratasys 3D printers provided the tools I needed to create a strong, safe, and durable adapter. 3 main parts were used to develop the drive wheel adapter. The original plastic wheel, the embedded drive gear, and the new wheel. The new wheel's rim is tapered from the hub to the tire, making sure the adapter fits flush with the rim angle and snugly on the hub's diameter reduces any side-to-side torque. This provides a safer design. I began by measuring and documenting the original gear and wheel assembly. Not wanting to recreate the wheel, no pun intended, I decided to keep the stock drive gear and attach it to the adapter, fastening them together using small screws. Measuring the diameter of the hub was simple. However, the taper from the hub to the outside of the rim proved more challenging. I went old school for a solution and ended up cutting a piece of cardstock until it matched the angle between the hub and rim. I placed a 1-inch line on the template to represent scale. SOLIDWORKS can utilize an image to draw over top of. This feature made it simple to get the angle of the adapter spot on. Several iterations of the adapter were modeled before the final version was decided on. What helped me make this tough engineering decision? SOLIDWORKS Simulation. If you are doing any type of design, knowing that your final version meets all your intended criteria can be a daunting task. SOLIDWORKS Simulation helped me answer the question of safety and durability throughout my design changes. The adapter is printed out of ABS material, which is nonlinear. I used SOLIDWORKS Simulation Premium to perform the nonlinear analysis of the adapter design iterations. The design needs to be tested for the power transfer from the motor and the weight of the vehicle. After some research and calculation, I arrived at a torque load of 560 inch-pounds applied by the motor to the end of the adapter. The Power Wheels Jeep itself weighs 22.5 pounds at each corner. Adding the maximum rider weight of 90 pounds, this equates to an upward force of 45 pounds. SOLIDWORKS Simulation provided a virtual testbed for understanding the different adapter iterations, strengths, and weaknesses. Focusing just on the torque load, the first adapter design used a minimal printed material approach, having a flange at the top and bottom for mounting. A high stress developed in an area of the adapter where the flange meets the body. Using the stress hotspot diagnostics, Simulation points out the area and recommends adding fillets. Missing the design flaw would have proven costly. Adding fillets to these regions removed the stress concentration and no hotspots remain. With the hotspots removed, the torque is more appropriately applied to the screw holes that hold the drive gear to the adapter. The next step is to analyze the adapter and drive gear assembly to understand how the force is transmitted between the parts. With the gear and adapter analyzed together, we can see that the torque is transferred directly through the 5 small screws. The drive gear has a rounded bottom and does not lay flat on the adapter, causing the screws to take even more of the load. Reporting high stress values in the hole regions indicates that this design is not a good choice. Went back to the drawing board and decided to incorporate the drive gear in the adapter design. One unified component eliminates the high load on the small screws. Applying the torque load now shows stress within the acceptable limits. Now that the torque load requirement is satisfied, the weight aspect of the loading needs to be validated. Knowing that the axle is solid steel and runs to the outside of the wheel assembly, there's little to no movement created due to the weight of the vehicle. I tested the adapter as though it was cantilevered, with no internal axle support. A worst case, if not impossible, scenario. The adapter passes with flying colors and the weight load is no longer a factor in the design. The final design of the adapter has a factor of safety of 2.7, proving to be safe and durable. Finalized and ready to go, the adapter is saved as a universal STL file type. Read into the Stratasys printer software, the model is oriented for best print quality. The moment of truth, will this adapter fit the wheel? I designed it in SOLIDWORKS. Of course it did. What began as a project born from fond childhood memories, SOLIDWORKS Simulation and Stratasys provided a design path to a new and improved Power Wheels that will continue to generate memories. Understanding any early design flaws and designing a more robust adapter was invaluable. Simulation proved the design was safe for the kids and durable enough to stand up to the day in and day out abuse of two young Jeepers. 5 years since the restoration, the adapter has held up commendably. After adding even more power and torque to the system, resulting in massive wheelies and crazy speed, the design has proven itself. Thanks to my grandparents for providing such a long-lasting gift. Please contact CATI to learn how to utilize digital prototypes and make your designs a reality with additive manufacturing. Click on the Jeep to read all about the Power Wheels Restoration Project.